Thank you for joining us again on AM 950 KOEL. We are joined with Bruce. He is with Wyffels, and so much has happened over the weekend. And since the last time we talked, Bruce, the activity in the field has just taken off and just flourished. A lot of activity over this past weekend. I know a lot of beans coming out, a lot of corn coming out, and a lot of tractor activity on the roadways. Bruce, what are you seeing? And more importantly, what are you hearing from our farmers?
Yeah, you're exactly right, Liz. Just a lot of things going on right now. Guys going back and forth between corn and beans, depending on what's fit and when. We had a little bit of snow in the north end of the territory last Sunday, Monday. It didn't really amount to much compared to some of our neighbors were a lot more unlucky than us. But just that little extra dampness slowed things down just a little bit. Guys got rolling again Monday and Tuesday. And I think a lot of guys switched to beans by mid to the end of the week. And we did have some rain on Friday that kind of shut us down unexpectedly again for a little bit. But over the weekend, things were rocking and rolling pretty good again.
And there is a lot of activity in and out of the field. So, just for everyone, slow down, be cautious, and be paying attention. Safety first, because we want to get this harvest in as safely as possible, as quickly as possible, but definitely as safely as possible.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, something I've been noticing, too, is just with the wet conditions, there's a lot of mud and slimy roads from trucks and wagons leaving the field. Just got to be aware of that, especially if you get a little moisture and that quickens the road up again.
Bruce, as far as the beans go, I've heard a couple reports of some split pods as far as maybe even some beans that are regerminating. Are you hearing anything up your way?
Yeah, we have seen that a little bit. Seems like the worst of it is in the early maturity beans, and the earlier they were planted, the worse it is, just because they've been mature and ready to come out of the field for quite some time now. So that seems to be where the biggest portion of the damage is. It sounds like as guys get into later planted and later maturity beans, we're not seeing that as much anymore.
Is there anything that we are seeing as far as damaging the crops?
I haven't seen a whole lot in my area myself, but I know there's some concerns with sprouting corn kernels, especially if the ear sat upright and open. Is some concern with some ear rots out there and some kernel rots. Some of those can cause some livestock effects, so we have to be aware of what's going on out there. And
Bruce, now I know we've had some pretty gusty winds, some pretty windy days that have come through. Have you seen anything with stock standability and the integrity of the stocks?
Yeah, Liz, I think the last time we talked, one of my biggest concerns was the standability of the corn out there. We knew early on in the season that it was probably going to be an issue, and we've had a lot of wind, a lot more moisture still. So, yeah, definitely stock quality and standability is a huge concern. It doesn't really matter the variety in the right spot or the wrong spot, whichever way you want to put it, especially if things didn't have fungicide or they ran out of nitrogen early. There is definitely some standability issues.
Bruce, before I let you go, anything else you want to share with our listeners for today?
Yeah, I mean, even with all the challenges we've had this year, product performance has been strong. In our district especially, we've got pretty high yield potential out there still, and we're pretty lucky we've been in kind of a garden. Even with the massive amount of moisture we've had, things look pretty good. So, Our Wyffels lineup is very strong. There's a couple products, 4196 and 5516, that are rising to the top in a lot of plots and side-by-sides that we're really, really excited about going forward into next year.
All right. And, of course, we'll hear more about that in our next interview with Bruce from Wyffels. Again, Bruce, if anybody wants to reach out to you or any other rep from Wyffels, how do they reach the website?
Yeah, the easiest way to reach out to a rep or a dealer is go to the Wyffels website, www.wyffels.com. There's a search box in the upper right-hand corner. You can put in your zip code, and you will find your nearest DSM or dealer.
All right. Again, have a very safe and plentiful harvest, and we'll be speaking with Bruce in a couple of weeks. Thanks so much, Bruce.
Thanks, Liz.